what is minimal biology? Minimal biology explores the interface between physics and the life sciences and asks the question, what makes matter come alive? Minimal biology is exciting because it breaks down boundaries, it breaks down silo thinking, it is free roaming over all disciplines in the sciences and uniquely combines them. In synthetic biology, we learned how to apply engineering principles to create lifelike processes from defined individual parts. This was all carbon-based. So now we are moving away from this. In minimal biology, we are completely open to radically new approaches, radically new ideas, where we ask, does it have to be carbon? Can it also be other materials? Can it be inorganic materials? Can we use whatever we have in our disposal in chemistry and in biology and in physics? If we have defined parameters, if we can make model systems which we can completely control because we have built them from defined parts, then we can develop better diagnostics methods, better therapeutic methods, better models to test therapies and to test drugs which we are developing. The Max Planck Society is one of the most prestigious research societies in the world. And there are many Max Planck institutes with eminent scientists in Germany. The Max Planck Society also reaches out to international partners by establishing Max Planck centers in key area of expertise, which the Max Planck Society then brings into its fold through these international collaborations. It is great to have this Max Planck Center coming to Bristol. That is a great achievement, and it shows the strength of the research which is done in Bristol in this area, and we are very proud. The Max Planck Center comprises 6 scientists, 3 in Bristol and 3 in Germany. Those are people with complementary expertise arrayed around minimal biology. In Bristol, we will have actually a laboratory in the chemistry building, housing the personnel. Training the next generation of scientists is a paramount objective of the Max Planck Center. This we will do by great science, which we will be doing together with our postdocs, together with our PhD students. So the vision of the Max Planck Center in the long term is not to restrict ourselves just to the data processing algorithms which define lifelike processes, whatever and in whichever form they may be, but to bring into this fold also the data processing algorithms which define our environment, big data in healthcare, quantum computing. In all of these areas, Bristol is particularly strong, and so is the Max Planck Gesellschaft. Exciting times are ahead of us. This week, Brexit was supposed to happen. But you see, science is international. Scientists speak with one language. Scientific success requires cooperation. And we are very happy that in these politically turbulent times we set a signal that we are reaching out to our European continental partners and they are reaching out to us. And where countries move apart, scientists move closer.